Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and first and foremost, I want to wish you all a very happy new year. Now, you might have noticed I haven't been on here for a week or so, and that's because I've been sick. So today is the first day where my voice is, you know, back to somewhat normal, maybe a little deeper than normal. Hi, how's it going? But it's definitely, you know, you guys can understand what I'm saying now. So anyway, I've got an exciting tutorial for you. We're going to be messing around with layer blending modes inside of Photoshop. And if any of you have done any compositing or collaging, this is just going to change the way that you work inside of Photoshop. I've got some cool little tricks and tips I'm going to show you. But before I do, I just want to mention, maybe you've seen it, maybe you haven't, but we're right on the cusp of 100,000 subscribers right now. We're just a few hundred subscribers away. So if you're not a subscriber on Photoshop Cafe, hit the subscribe button right now. Jump on this exciting journey that we're going through with Photoshop, Lightroom, photography, and a little bit of video stuff. And without further ado, let's jump into this week's tutorial. So happy new year. Let's get started. So let's talk about a couple of things with layer blending mode. So we're gonna do some cool things here, some collaging with these different layers here in a second. But first of all, I'm gonna show you just quick overview, because I have other tutorials where I go more in depth. But there's some different blend modes here. If we look at these layers, so let's start on this side. Notice that we've got black there with white writing. On the other side, we've got a layer there, it's white with black writing. Now, you could go through all the process of trying to, you know, extract this or whatever you want to do, but using layer blend modes, there's a lot of things we can do, and in fact, they're broken into different groups. If we look at it, here's the darkened group, here's the lighting group, this group here works 50% gray, and this one here I call the utilitarian group, and this one here works with color. So if we start maybe on the lighten group, and if we choose lighten, notice what it does is it hides black and allows the color to show through. So if we change this to maybe some of the darkening modes, it's going to do the opposite. Now what it's going to do is it's going to hide white and show black. Right now you can see darken, but usually multiply will work better for this kind of thing. If we've got black that we want to hide, there's our darken groups. Well, we want to go into our lighten groups. And a way to remember the lighten versus the darken is they give priority. So think of the darkened groups as giving priority to those dark colors, hiding the lighter colors. And then the same thing, the lightened groups give priority to the lighter colors and hide the darker colors, especially black. So what we do is we're just gonna grab our black layer here and we're gonna go in here and we're gonna choose lighten. And you can see it does a pretty good job. But for some reason, screen's gonna work better. So just kind of remember that if you wanna hide black or white, the second one down, multiply and screen seem to be the two that work the best for those kind of things. Now, a lot of it's gonna happen with the background and the foreground. If the background is lighter or darker, it's gonna affect it. So don't worry, you don't have to try and memorize all of this. I've actually got a free ebook. Check out the link underneath and just download that ebook, and that's gonna give you everything you need to know about how the different layer blending modes, and I even have a chart of how they all work. So happy new year, that's my gift to you. I hope you enjoy it. Now let's jump into our image here. And that was really insincere the way I said that. I mean, I really do hope you enjoy it. Not like some like, yeah, okay, moving on. So here we go, we've got a couple of layers here and we've got a few things we can do for fun. So we're gonna do some compositing, collaging, and we've got this lightning kind of stuff, and then we've got the woman in a red dress over the top, and then we've got some snow. So in order to make this work, we want to play around with some blending modes. Now, as you already know, if we choose this one here, it's going to show the lighter areas. It's going to hide the darks. It's kind of interesting in there. Now, if we go into some of the other ones, we can do different things. But the opposite with the screen. Notice now we're showing the highlight areas and hiding the darkened areas. And to be honest, this looks pretty good right there. That's actually not bad. Can you imagine the amount of compositing and cutting out you would do to do this with our blend modes? Really, when it comes to compositing and creating stunning images in Photoshop, there's two keys. It's layer blend modes and layer masks. And I cover those a lot in my tutorials. So anyway, moving on, let's go and have a look at the other group here where we're working with the areas that work with the 50% gray. So like the overlay modes. Okay, that's not very exciting, but what about soft light? Nah. Hard light? Not bad. Vivid light? And you can see, you know, there's a lot of different blending modes here, and there's a lot of different things we can do with them. Now I'm going to show you a cool tip that's going to show you how to try these on, like trying on clothes. Like, let's see what each one goes through. Let's audition them one at a time. And here's the easy way to do it. And this tip really did change my life when I figured it out. So we're just going to go to the top. So we're in normal blending mode right now, and you can tell right there. Then what we're going to do is make sure the move tool is turned on. If you don't have the move tool on, it can act a little bit weird. And now we're just going to hold down the shift key on the keyboard, and we're going to hit plus. And notice as we do this, now we're cycling through the blend modes. So we can try them all on and see the ones that we like. And you can see some of them are working better than others, but it's so quick to go through them all. Like right there, we did it. We went through all of them. So now if you're moving through them and you think, oh, maybe I prefer the previous one, holding down the shift key, hit the minus key, and you can go back. So we can compare this. This screen versus lighten. Just shift, minus, and plus. I'm liking that one a lot more. So as you can see there, the shift, minus, and plus. Now this also works on brushes. That's why if you have the B key selected and the brushes are active, it's going to change the blending mode for those or across the options bar at the top. That's why you want to make sure you hit the V key for the move tool. Then that way, just the layer blend modes are going to change and not the other ones. All right, so let's have a look at one more we can add on here. What we're going to do is add some snow on here. And why don't we do our little trick here? Let's just go make sure that that layer is selected. And I'm going to hit the shift plus key. And we're just going to cycle through some of these until we see one that maybe works. You know, that's kind of cool with the colors. That's color dodge. I might not have thought of choosing color dodge normally. That one there's not bad. Overlay. Soft light's kind of cool too. Okay. So we're cycling through these, and you can get some really cool psychedelic effects, of course. And when you see some of these effects, this is how they're created. Just using blending modes. So if you remember, I think I liked the color dodge looked pretty good. So let's have a look at that color dodge. That's looking pretty nice. Now we can also adjust the opacity. So we're not stuck with just, you know, the color in itself. So if we drop the opacity down a little bit, we can see, you know, maybe blend it a little bit more subtle. And also, you know, if we want to hide it from this side here, we can add a layer mask. And notice that white means it's doing nothing. Black, if we change it, will hide the areas that we paint. So we're going to go B for the brush. And let's hit the right bracket key and make a nice big brush. Okay, so now I can just paint over here gently and paint away the area maybe that I don't want to have that overlay on that layer. And we can create some kind of a composite here. So if I just hit F for full screen. All right, guys, so now you can see how easy it is to make complex looking compositions, but they're actually super easy. All you're doing is just changing a couple of blend modes and a couple of layer masks. And when you look at all the professional work, essentially most of what's going on, that's it. When you see magazine ads, movie posters, blending modes, and layer masks are huge. Now, I do have some training that you guys can check out at Photoshop Cafe where I go more in depth and some compositing and different things like that. I'm working on some new stuff that I'm going to have coming for you this year, working with blending modes, but you can grab that ebook for free. Also check out some of the other tutorials I have. Smash that like button into dust if you like this. Don't forget, if you're not part of the Cafe crew, join our family right now. Hit the subscribe button right now. If you have subscribed, make sure you hit that little bell so you're notified when I do a new tutorial, which is every single week, unless I get sick like I did last week. But it's actually only been a week since I've done one, so yeah, but I've been doing 2 or 3 a week lately. Okay, so anyway, guys, what do you guys think about this tutorial? Add a comment. Let me know some suggestions. Maybe you've got some cool little tips or some things like that. Or you've got some questions where maybe you're stuck. I'm quite happy to help you. I look at the questions. I read the questions. And I reply to them in the comments there. So anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Until next time. You know, I was thinking about changing it. You know, like I always say, I'll see you at the cafe. That's kind of how I end the videos. Now, a motto we've had on Photoshop Cafe since the very beginning, since the year 2000, I know I'm dating myself, is we always had create, don't steal. So what do you guys think? Do you think I should finish off with, I'll see you at the cafe? You guys like that? Or would it be better to remember, guys, create, don't steal. So add a comment underneath. Let me know which one I should use. And if you want me to keep saying, I'll see you at the cafe, I will. I know it's not really that important. I know, but I think a new year, I want to change it up a little bit. So anyway, guys, thanks. Bye.